fresh. Let us pray. This service in captivity for the Reverend Carlyle Lynch, who was the rector of the St. Matthew Parish School. And gentlemen, I have to give thanks to God for having seen through this ministry in this part of God's kingdom. And so this evening we give Lord thanks and praise for so much the Reverend Father Carlyle. We begin service with the senior sentence for your company on page 60. The Lord has declared his salvation, his righteousness he has openly displayed for all the nations to see. Blessed. Hear us, O Lord,
and your mercy is great.
We exalt you, O God, our Savior.
I praise your name forever and ever.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
So be it together.
Father, come together in the name of the Son of Jesus Christ, our Redeemer. To all who worship, praise, and thanksgiving.
To you, Lord, for all our glory, you are the source of all goodness. Let us worship you and give you your peace and give you power. Your Spirit, may you ever rejoice in the divine presence of our mercy and tender Lord.
Amen.
In my introduction, I forgot to welcome our Archdeacon South, the Venerable Archdeacon Edwin Primus, who will be doing most of the service this afternoon, this evening. in him. 4:64. Do you pray?
Thank you.
First reading.
Amen.
chapter 10, beginning at verse 32. The woman rose, went up to Jerusalem, and Jesus was walking ahead of them. They were amazed, and those who followed were afraid. He took the 12 aside again and began to tell them what was to happen to him. See, we are going up to Jerusalem, and the Son of Man will be handed over to the chief priests and the scribes, and they will condemn him to death. Then they will hand him over to the Gentiles. They will mock him and spit on him and throw him and kill him, and after 2 days he will rise again. James and John, the sons of Zebedee, came forward to him and said to him, "Teacher, we want you to do for us whatever we ask of you." And he said to them, "What is it you want me to do?" And he said to him, "Grant us to sit, one at your right hand and one at your left in your glory." But Jesus said to them, "You do not know what you are asking. Are you able to bring the cup that I drink, or be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with?" They replied, "We are able." Then Jesus said to them, "The cup that I drink, you will drink, and with the baptism with which I am baptized, you will be baptized. But to sit at my right hand or at my left is not mine to grant, but it is for those for whom it has been prepared." When the 10 moons, they began to be angry with James and John. So Jesus called them and said to them, "You know that among the Gentiles, those whom they recognize as the ruler of the body over them, and the great ones are tyrants over them. But it is not so among you. But whoever wishes to become you must be your servants, and whoever wishes to be first among you must be slave of all. For the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for men." The word of the Lord.
Amen. And therefore, as you come together this afternoon, the evening, he is offering thanks to God for the opportunity to serve as a pastor, a teacher, a counselor, a friend, a candidate, tell me about getting it from candidate. All in all, faithfulness to God. And giving thanks to God, he brings his family in the picture for his family to follow him along the way. Amen? And very important, because sometimes being a priest can be a very lonely journey. And these people around you, people of understanding, who love, to support you. But you are called to serve. We are called to serve. And sometimes that calling is not easy. Someone said, and I read it today when I realized I had to do more than say I wanted to come more to the life of Carlyle Lynch. Someone wrote, I just want to quote what the person said. But I think it is very appropriate as we give our chance this evening for Carlyle. And the person said, a success. He said, no one who achieved success does so without acknowledging the talent of others. No one who achieved success does so without acknowledging the talent of others. And Father Carlyle in his journey continued for of the vestry, the various congregations, the individuals who support him on this journey, who walk with him, who talk with him, who encourage him, say, Father, hold on, don't give up, hold on, we are praying for you. And that inspired by Carlyle to give his best to God. I think no one can deny the fact that we give God time for him to see that Father Carlyle gave his best to God. Even when he So he is going to come to God, say to God, Heavenly Father, in spite of and in spite of my challenges, I gave my best to you. So I recognize that what I was doing was not my own. You called me, you nourished me, you sustained me, and you set me out to do your work. And for this, we must be grateful and thankful. So yes, we are given that by a man who, is in a relationship with Almighty God. A man who knows God, not about God, is a different thing. Some people know God, and some people know about God. But a Carlyle knows God. And you walk and talk with him along that narrow way. But he lives, and Carlyle said, I know he lives. He lives within my heart. And that's why he continues to serve and soldier all and all for Calacara, you know, held and told his ancestors near and dear to him. Oh, yeah. You will die for St. Andrew. And you will rise again for St. Andrew. And die and rise again. Because he was placed there by a bishop here, but the bishop put inside that Carlyle was a man of the family at that time. And for this, we are grateful, and for this, we are thankful. Father Carlyle was one of my biggest supporters and encouragement in my own ministry. And I discovered in my journey, I encountered Carlyle with family, that Carlyle saw and see more than we see and know ourselves. That we see beyond us, what you want to give up, easier to cut. And many a time they call and say, well, I just take it in. Come in. Then what? To know that someone cares. Someone calls each other day and night and says, I'm checking on you. And you share the story. I say, how do you do? Now hold on. I get a few sides here again, right? But I'm holding on. Because he loves him. So we thank God for him this afternoon and evening. The fear and fear with God as a priest in God's spirit goes beyond measure for this man of God. This man who has grown up years ago, a man who can all. Because you know God has a purpose for him. Let us mean so. God has purpose for him. I saw some yesterday that God has a plan for my life. God has a plan for Carlyle and Carlyle journey along the way. And because of his obedience to God, many, 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 many have come to know Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Many have come to understand that life is a journey. That life is worth living. And life is not worth living if God is at the center of your being. So Carlyle encouraged many to walk by faith and not by sight. That's important for us. Give thanks to the Lord for his good, for his mercy in your life.
Yes.
Now, what do you think? What? So, people have said, Andrew, I've got a Carlyle offered thanks to God for his opportunity to serve here in this place. I want you and we go together to give one thanks. The thanks to God for Carlyle and his family. Thank you, God, for his caring nature. Thank you, God, for his sacrifice to build St. Andrew and to leave a legacy for those who are coming behind. Very important. When we walk and talk, we must hear Father Carlyle go to his parents. We must see his presence. When you are broken, when you want to give up, say thank you, Father Carlyle, because of you, I am now able to face this time with victory in Jesus. Thank you, brothers and sisters. All that is to be done with you. We are not to be happy. We are blessed with many cared souls. We are blessed with many cared clergy, so something don't fix. We are blessed with some clergy carrying who will go the extra mile to ensure that all God's people are one. That they know we are Christians by our love and by our love. And because of Carlyle's ministry, we give more time for, and we give time for this evening. Many would have passed by and said, oh, all those people of St. Andrew's Parish love the Lord and love Jesus. Because of his compassion, his love, his forgiving music, and sometimes, as I say, Carlyle, you put yourself too much. But God is okay, well, what would you? That was what called me for. I said, nonetheless, you can't. And then some was telling me, sometimes God will put himself beyond the measure. He said, I have to go here and go there. How are you going to get there? And that is the sign of a true servant of God. Who not just finds standing, will rise and go forth and shine in God's kingdom. Amen. Think of God's time for that spirit that he has. But we thank God for that spirit as well this evening. Carlyle, encourage us. Of many, many, many of people. Some years ago, I think someone wrote that article, the opposite. Extolling the quality of a certain kind of person. Are you getting it? And I know that your person, talking about how Carlyle touched that person, how Carlyle meant so much to young people of St. Andrews. I said, oh, that's wonderful. And we will continue to celebrate the life of Father Carlyle, who is not in active ministry at this time, but the journey continues. The journey of service to God and God's people. And give God thanks that despite the fact that he is not 100% in health, he continues to despise the cross of Jesus. And I give thanks God for that. God, God bless you and God forever and ever. To all of us, Father Paul in Africa, Father Carlyle, we know that he was a pastor of pastors. He cared, he showed mercy, he listened, and gave appropriate advice from time. So when we read 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 16 and 18, that rejoice in the Lord always, pray continually, and every day give thanks for this the will of Christ for you. So Father Carlyle, rejoice. You are still well, you are going down to God for divine protection, the anointing over the year and through the year. Rejoice all of you. Can you just pray without ceasing? But God will for you to bless even at this time in your life. I hope the man will find without that, but the Carlyle will be. That you perhaps somewhere along the line will establish some memorial in time for the life and business of Father Carlyle, who served faithfully, and he's given time, he is given time. I said, how many times do you serve Father Carlyle now? He said, Father, this is my time. He gave time to God, and God has given time to God for them. Is that wonderful? I have given time to God and my family. We are giving thanks to God for St. Andrew Carlyle to support their love and encouragement to my ministry. That's what he told me. So I encourage them to understand. But I want to encourage you to be faithful, to be thankful. Always give your best to God. Even when you feel humiliated, when you feel like you're up, remember, God is with you. God at your side. And my favorite colors, and I can sing them like this. Hold on, and on. And a color. Hold on, St. Andrew. Hold on. Hold on. Trust on. God has something in store for you. Wait. And God will do the same. So, color, rejoice. Give God time. Just the Lord all you. We are praying for you and your family. That God will bless you and keep you safe. God is going to open the way for you to grow and be strengthened as a family of God in his faith and the other. Thanksgiving for God's goodness. that giveth to God. Yeah. Thank you to God for mercy on us. But God was kept clear. When things were good, not so good, when it became good again, God kept continue to walk by faith and not by faith. God is the Lord, all is my God. Despite the retirement, I'm sure you will have some more life in you to share. I hope you'll be able to capture so that knowledge and value that you have here, that the church will not, the church of God will not be left and left alone. Give that. But this is the day the Lord has made. Rejoice and be glad. Be your day. Oh, happy day. This is by the thing.
Thank you.
Back. One to the shared blessing of the kingdom comes. And the vision will come, the fever of life is over, and the work is done. The Lord is mercy grant us here, of all rest and peace in life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. To the call for silence until 72. Almighty and everlasting God, let our prayer of sight be as incense, the lifting up of our hands as the evening sacrifice. Give us grace to behold you, present in your word as sacrifice, and to recognize in the life of those around us. Stop us, the flame of our love will burn in the heart of the tongue as you hold this passion and let it burn in us. To eternal life and to the ages. Amen. God, we're looking for that.
Let us give thanks to God our Father for all his gifts to fill the soul of our life. For the beauty and honor of creation, for all the contributions to the lives of men and women, revealing the image of Christ.
We thank you, Lord.
For their food, for homes and families, and church.
We thank you, Lord.
For minds to think and hearts to love. For health, strength, and skill to work, for leisure to rest and play.
Thank you, Lord.
For those who are brave and courageous, patient in suffering, and patient in adversity.
Thank you, Lord.
For all who pursue peace, justice, and truth.
We thank you, Lord.
Today, we give thanks especially for Reverend Father Carlyle Lynch and his family.
We thank you, Lord.
For the communion of saints in all times and places.
We thank you, Lord.
Above all, we give you thanks for the great mercies and promises given to us in Christ Jesus our Lord. To him we praise and glory with you, O Father, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Almighty God, Father of all mercies, be on this servant in the most humble and happy times for the goodness and loving kindness in all sent for thee. We bless you for creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life. But above all, for your immeasurable love, redemption of the world, in our Lord Jesus Christ. For the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And give us, pray, such a sense of all mercies that our hearts are fairly powerful, and that we show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but our life, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before your holiness and righteousness all the way. This prayer to our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
We thank you for the gift of may be your land, gentle of feet, light your hearts, and the strength of our life. Keep us in the sense of the soul of the
soul, in the power of the Holy Spirit, and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
parents run closer with each other, because God's plan is that two of you should come together to share the act of creation. And therefore, one of you has a responsibility. And so, you should have that loving and that caring to the end of your day with the child. And if we could think on that and help it to happen, then in the next couple of years, we will not have to lament into the experiences that surround us. That's one. And I want one more to share with you. God always has the good plan. We don't believe it, we don't always understand it. But He has the good plan. And I pray that in the face of whatever experience you have, you can see God's hand eventually, if not immediately. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.